You will even see that it sometimes will become a new miasm. One of the remedies here is a new miasm. And column four is about nurturing, about being in about being rooted, having roots, and therefore about balance. Think of a wheat of a field of wheat moving in the wind. We always ask then, where is the seventh? So I'm saying that the seventh is to come, but the truth is, and I believe I've shown it to you, that there is actually a more ancient table, the ancient plants. Not only tuya, like copodium, all the ferns, the mosses, the cicuses, the ginkgo, the ephedra, the velvetia, and then the conifers. Now the conifers are the sixth, belong to the sixth day of creation. And in column four, we therefore find the equilibrium between those two forces, because the ego, which is born only in the flowering plants, in the human stage, I would say, is born through the maternal feminine birth-giving quality. So we will find it the most stronger in column one, column two, where we said we start to see in column two, we start to see a separation. In column three, the cactus says we fight it. And in column three, we just fight to try to find an equilibrium between the masculine and the feminine. And therefore the table is divided to this pink and blue, just to remind us where we are. And it is very helpful because until the middle of column four, people will be present more feminine qualities. So of course in men, it's easier to find feminine qualities. And in column five and six, in women, it is easier to find that they're having masculine qualities, but still it is there. So realizing where you are oftentimes allows you to differentiate the diagnose. So we will start with the poales. In the passage, they were called graminales. So in all textbook, they're sometimes called graminales. Now they're called poales, botanical orficle. Lot and every 10, 20 or 30 years, they change names. Okay, so by the way, this is an old picture. The orchids are not belonging here. The orchids belong to column six. We will talk about it, but what we have here is the graminales. The younger stage up to adolescence of column four. Now, the poales, the grains, are the largest monocot order, both in number of species, geographical distribution, and anything you can, and even amount. The grains are the basic food for men and animal. The sorghum, Avena sativa, the triticum, the oryza, the sugar, and many others. They're the basic food. Now, grains are unable to generate big trees. You don't have grain trees. They create masses that cover field all over the world. And because they rely on masses, they usually don't need insects as pollinators, rather by wind. And so their pollination, in simple words, is based on the family being together, not on one planet there and another plant 2 kilometers away, but on a mass of us growing together. So we don't, the wind will is enough to pollinate us. We need the family. Now the roots of the grains are usually not deep. They're thick, but not they don't go deep. They have roots issues. And they, as I said, they don't know how to make a trunk. So whenever they stay erect, it's due to silicate in the stem. Again, so how do our learn to be erect, to stay balanced, yet stay flexible? Because if you're not flexible, the wind will break you eventually. Move with the wind, but not break, and also not being uprooted.